how to control ESP32 with your voice. Perhaps the outcome makes things easier, but the process of doing this might be a little bit complicated. Let me explain to you. So first, let me explain to you the system via this diagram. Once you understand this diagram and the things I'm going to tell you in the code, you'll get the things easier. So first, when we power up the ESP32 for the first time, it generates a QR code. Now, this QR code contains the information needed to securely identify the device during setup. So we scan this QR code with the ESP RainMaker app on our phone. After scanning the QR code, the ESP RainMaker app opens the provisioning process. So the phone temporarily connects to the ESP32 via a Bluetooth connection. And then we send the Wi-Fi credentials from our phone to the ESP32. Then once the ESP32 receives the Wi-Fi credentials, it connects to your home router. Inside the ESP32, we have a node which represents the ESP32 itself. Other than this, we have one or more devices, like a light or a relay or whatever, and parameters such as on and off. So all of these is defined in the code. So we don't have to do nothing in the ESP RainMaker app. So now the ESP32 uses the Wi-Fi router to access the internet. Now, this router is simply a gateway, so it doesn't control the device. It just provides connectivity. So after connecting to Wi-Fi, ESP32 registers itself with an ESP32 cloud. So the cloud stores the device's status, control commands, synchronization between the phone and the ESP32. So this allows the device to be controlled from anywhere. Now, for example, if you connect components, LEDs, and let's say a relay, on the ESP32 RainMaker app, automatically will appear widgets for LED and the relay. So you don't have to do nothing, as I said, in RainMaker app. So now, if we, for example, press this LED widget, which is it's like a Boolean variable, it's either on or off. When you press it, this information goes to the cloud, and from the cloud it goes to the ESP32 through a Wi-Fi router. And then the ESP32 reacts and turns on or off the LED or whatever the component. Now, if you use a voice assistant like a Google Assistant, the flow is exactly the same. But differently, we just use our voice to give commands from our phone. Now, let's go through the code and understand how the ESP RainMaker actually controls the ESP32. So, this is our code. And first of all, we include these libraries on our code. So, how are we gonna include these libraries? Not from the library manager, because it's not available there. So what we're gonna do, you go to the description and copy this link. So this one, it's Espressif's official package for ESP32, and just paste that link here. Now, if you have another link here already, you just put a comma in between them and paste the link. After that, we define the LED pin, which I named here as a relay pin, and the service name together with pop. So the service name is the device name shown during the provisioning, and the pop is proof of possession, which adds security during setup. After that, here with this line, we create a virtual switch called LED. So this is actually how we're going to refer to our component, in this case, which is LED. So this device will appear inside the ESP RainMaker app and can be controlled using the app or the voice assistant. And this function is extremely important. So this is called when every time a command is sent from our phone to the ESP32. And then here we check which device sent the command and which parameter is changed. So if this value is true, the relay or the LED or whatever component is turns on. And if it's false, it turns off. Then this function handles system events during provisioning. And when the provision starts on the serial monitor, a QR code is generated and we scan this QR code through ESP RainMaker app. And so this way we send the Wi-Fi credentials to the ESP32. And this line confirms that the ESP32 has successfully connected to Wi-Fi. On void setup is actually where everything is initialized. So we set the relay pin as output and keep it low as default. And here is the RainMaker node. A node represents the ESP32 itself in the ESP RainMaker ecosystem. So this node will contain all devices like switch, sensors, or whatever device we're using. So we attach the callback function to the switch and then add the switch to the node. And then we start the RainMaker. So here is where the cloud communication is started. And here, this starts the BLE provision. The ESP32 waits the QR code to be scanned by the phone and sends the Wi-Fi credentials. Now, this is all about the code. And now let's go to the RainMaker app. But before going to ESP32 RainMaker app, let's make the circuit and upload the code. So first of all, the circuit is easy. You have to just grab a LED and connect it to the GPIO2. And after this, we upload the code. So from the tools section on boards, select ESP32 dev module and select your port. For mine is COM13. If you don't know your port, you can check from a device manager. After that, disable the erase all flash before sketch upload option. So this is actually when you want to factory reset your ESP32 or delete completely the previous code and all the information from the previous code, you enable this. But for the first time, we don't need it. So after that, select your flash size here. But for the most ESP32s, it's 4 megabytes. And this is the most important part. Here, you have to select huge app. So 3 megabytes, no OTA. Or RainMaker 4 megabytes, no OTA might work as well. And finally, disable the PS RAM. And we're done. So the upload speed is 115,200. And so let's upload the code. So once the code is uploaded, open the serial monitor. All right, guys, so I got this error message instead of the QR code. This is actually a memory flash crash. So you remember on tools, this part, the partition scheme. So here actually, maybe if I choose the RainMaker 4 megabytes, it'll work. Now let's try again. All right, guys, so there you go. We got the QR code on the serial monitor. But I did something else out of the record. I enabled the flash memory erasing. So I deleted all the previous code and information from the ESP32. So now let's just install the ESP32 RainMaker and scan the QR code. So after installing the ESP32 RainMaker app, yeah, here you can see my previous device, my previous project. And here plus and just scan the code. Yeah, it already scans. Please turn on Bluetooth and try again. Okay, let's turn on Bluetooth. Let's try again. Yeah, this may take a little bit of time. And just select your Wi-Fi address here and write your password. Yeah, it sent the Wi-Fi credentials. Now it will just configure the node association and set it up. And done. This is the widget that the app created for controlling the LED. So I'm recording with my secondary phone. I don't use it, but I just found it on my desk. And because I don't have a camera, I record with my phone. Now let's set this up with our voice on Google Home. So you download the Google Home from Play Store or App Store if you're using an iOS, and you press this icon to add a new device, and here you select the third option, and yeah, here you can see the ESP RainMaker on the first place because I have used it before. But you have a bunch of other smart home systems as well. So let's reconnect the account. Continue. Agree and continue. And here you have to log in or sign up with that account that you used in ESP32 RainMaker. Hi from my dreadful quality camera again. So as you can see, guys, so right now we are on Google Home. So our system works with Google Home as well. So let's turn on. Yep, let's turn on and turns off properly. So the only thing left is setting up this system with voice assistant. So make sure, first of all, from the settings that you allowed Google Assistant, and after that, hey Google, control my devices from Google Home.
I can help you control your devices from Google Home. What would you like to do?
So because I did this setting before, and now it doesn't require any permission. So after saying this to Google, you just give the permission to have access on your Google Home and turn on the lights.
Yep. Okay, I've turned on the LED.
As you can see, guys, it accessed to Google Home and turned on the light. Hey Google, turn off the lights.
Turning off LED.
Yep. So that's how you, let me change the camera. So basically that's how you can control your home appliances by your voice. Now, this is a simple example of using ESP32 with Google Assistant, but you can use relays instead of this LED to control bigger appliances. For example, the ceiling lights, or maybe the security system, or whatever. In incoming videos, I'm gonna do a project related to this topic. So if you want to get notified, subscribe to my channel. And if this video was helpful to you, don't forget to put a like down there. And if it wasn't, or you didn't like it, you can put a dislike as well. So that's it all. Thanks for watching, and see you on the next one.